Gather round, friends. Come close away, people. For from far away we bring to you a story. Selected beyond the snowy Sarmatian mountains and over the deep river on the far side. Story from the cold lands in the east that was kept hidden in the shads and whispered around the fire.
Yes, dear people, today we bring to you a tale that was never told. A tale of two lights, the occult and the narrated. A tale of divine teachings and traditional knowledge. Tale of the King of Kings and the crown that lies here on earth. The tale of righteous souls and distant sparks. A tale of the Kabbalah. This is a tale of darkness, too. A tale of the other side, of fear and hatred. This is a story of upper and lower worlds, and the everlasting light that runs in between them. Far, far away, looking east, into the vast plains of great Russia. Long, long ago, there lived a people, a nation that has been far from home and was never able to find it again. Living in small villages, they kept their customs and traditions inherited to them from their great forefathers. Religion was the last thing they tried to hold on to. In 1537, the Jews of Saxony are expelled. 1543, Martin Luther publishes his book, The Jews and Their Lies. 1555, in Ancona, Italy, 25 reclaimed Jewish men are burned at the stake. 1569, Pope Paul orders the burning of thousands of sacred Hebrew books. 1648, the Cossack Revolt and War.
50,000 Jewish men are murdered. 1657. The Jews of Poland are blamed for high treason. 1745. The Jews of Prague and Bohemia are expelled.
And in those very times, holy individuals and righteous souls discovered the secrets of the Kabbalah. It was a passage to transcendent knowledge, a way towards the light, a light so bright and warm that it filled every chamber of one's heart. The truth was now given to them, and suddenly nothing else mattered. Their terrible everyday problems gave way to a direct communication with angels and spirits. Now, they were able to influence and shape the whole turning of their lives. The very knowledge of creation was within their reach. Those chosen ones that were given the Kabbalah kept it away from all. Only merited and unique men were permitted a glimpse into the very Kabbalistic light. Overflowing with it, they retreated from society and deepened their study as they were pulling the divine into this very finite world.
Avinu malkeinu, choneinu voneinu,
commoners weren't aware of the doings of these men. They did not possess the capacities to absorb that potency, risking their own mental state and the misuse of their power. In the midst of this new age and the approaching of the divine light, they were kept in the dark, chased and tormented. But around those houses, something else dominated the air. Some sort of charm of magic that surrounded the place. The ground reacted differently to one's steps. The trees moved distinctively, gesturing their branches and leaves with awe and respect. Even the wind blew in a peculiar manner, and the sounds came from far away. Seraphic sounds these were, never heard in these lands. Sounds of song and glory that lured all the way from Jerusalem. Brothers coming out through the walls, so unite and open-hearted was their chant of fellowship and brotherhood. Their song was at times tormented and sad, and at times joyful and comforting. It came out directly from their loving hearts and wounded bodies. For them, it was all created by God and thus meant for Him. Like in kings' castles, their houses were called courts, for indeed, these were royal palaces where the presence of the King of Kings was almost tangible.